problem is to write a Python program to remove punctuations from a string. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to remove punctuations from a string. First of all, talking about punctuations, that what are punctuations? Let's understand that punctuations are all the special symbols that we have inside our keyboard. So what we need to do, if we have a string that has punctuations, like suppose someone has written hello exclamation mark, how are you question mark, so we want to remove the exclamation mark and the question mark from there, then how we will be able to remove it? Let's have a look on how this program can be written. First of all, to create this program, I'll be creating a variable called as punctuation. Inside this, I'll be storing all the punctuations that we have. So I'll be storing it inside the triple quotations. Why? Because our single quotation and double quotation, they also come in the categories of punctuations. That's why I'm including them inside the triple quotations. And I'll be writing all the punctuations over here. Once I have written the punctuation, I'll be taking the input from the user. That string is equals to int input, and we don't have to write it inside the input. We'll be asking just for input. That input, enter a number, not a number, enter a string here. Okay, once we have asked for the string, we have to create one empty string as well. Why empty string? Because the data that we will be storing it inside the string. Like after removing the punctuations from here, the data will be stored inside the empty string. So I'll be creating one empty string whose value is nothing but empty over here. Now what do we need to do? We need to use a for loop over here, which will iterate inside this string and check that if any of the letter is there inside our punctuation, in that case it will remove that letter and it will not add it inside our empty string. So we'll be using a for loop, that for I in string, and we'll be giving a condition that if whatever our I is, so I would be, let's say if we have taken a string called as hello, so I would be H. So if H is not there in our punctuations, in that case H will get added inside our empty string. So I have written if I not in PUNC, that means punctuations. If I is not there inside our punctuations, in that case we will add it to our empty string. So empty string plus is equals to I. So I will only get added over here if I is not there in our punctuations. And lastly, we will print empty string. So I'll just explain this once again. First of all, we created a variable called as punctuations. Then we have created a variable called as string, in which we have asked from the user for a user input, that enter a string here. After that, we have created another variable that is called as empty string, where we are storing the empty data. Right now it is just an empty string. Now what do we need to do? We need to iterate inside this string that is being given by the user. Suppose the user has written, instead of this, the user has written hello. Okay. So I'll be putting it inside over here, hello, exclamation mark, how are you, question mark. Okay, so next thing that we have done over here is for I in strings. That means we will iterate inside the string and we will go for each value over here. First, it will check for H, that if I is not in punctuation, that means if H is not in punctuation, that means if the H is not there inside these symbols, in that condition, H will get added over here. So H will get added over here. Okay. Then it will check for E. E is also not there. The E will get added. Then L. L is not there. L again is not there. O is again not there. Then again it will iterate and it will check for exclamation mark. That for I in string, if I not in punctuation, but I is there inside the punctuation. That means what it will do, it will completely skip this step. Again, it will skip for this one, skip for this one, skip for this one. Again, it will check for H. So H we will be talking about that. Then it will not skip the space over here, because space does not come in our punctuation. So it will give a space over here. And then H, it will check for capital H. Capital H is not there. Then it will write capital H over here. Then R, O, then W, then A, R, E, similarly Y, O, U. And lastly, the question mark will also be removed, because question mark is also there inside our punctuations. So this is how it will work. Now let's leave it empty and let's run and see what output we will get. So as soon as I run it, the output that I'm getting over here is hello and space, how are you? So both the punctuations have been removed. The exclamation marks along with the question marks have been removed. So if you want to remove this and take a user input, then in that case, we'll just run the program, and here you can write, hi, it is going to rain today. full stop. So three punctuations are there. One is exclamation marks, the other one is apostrophe, and the other one is the full stop. Let's run and see. So I'll just press enter, and the output that I am getting over here is hi without exclamation marks, h without the single quotation mark, that means an apostrophe, and lastly the dot is also missing, that means the dot has also been removed. So I hope guys this program is clear to you and you guys have no doubts and no questions. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.